Hello, I'm Charles Coves, Australasia's passion provocateur. Welcome to this week's episode of the Charles Coves Show, whether you're watching on YouTube, watching on Rumble, or whether you're listening via podcast. This is episode 146, and believe it or not, it's the third anniversary of starting this program back in March of 2020 at the start of the COVID games. 3 years of COVID games. This is episode 146. So we could have done over 3 years, 156 episodes. So that's not bad in 3 years to only miss 10 episodes. For those of you who have been on this journey with us for the 3 years, thank you very much. And we look forward to your support in helping to spread the message. In this week's episode, I give you the reasons why we have plenty of emergencies, but no climate emergency. Climate emergency is a fraudulent, misleading religion designed to enrich the elites at the expense of the rest of us. Since the 70s, when I started university, we've had climate cooling, climate warming, climate change, and now climate emergency. Can you see the pattern? Every few years, the wording changes because the fraud is shown to be a fraud. Do your own thinking. Invest your precious time in understanding this issue. Your future and the future of your family depends on it. I love the planet, and I share the evidence in this episode of that love. We have soil and landscape and waste emergencies. We need to solve them, and we can. But we do not have a climate emergency. Do not be mistaken. Do not be misled. Do not be defrauded. I'm confident this episode will help you gain new perspectives and new insights and new confidence about the ability of us human beings, men and women, to solve our problems, to solve our real emergencies. We can choose to do this, and that choice depends on being well informed. Our format for the show is that I share today's big idea. I share some resources to help you think about or expand your thinking about the big idea. A quick review of some crucial happenings in the week, and lastly, the foundational principles for this show and more details about my background are now contained at the end of the show for regular viewers and listeners who have already seen that portion, and that part is designed for newer viewers and listeners. So let's get into today's big idea. I urge you to become knowledgeable about the alleged climate emergency. In fact, you know, they'll use the climate emergency as an excuse to stop people drinking coffee. That, oh, gosh, imagine that. Take an interest, a deep interest in this topic. There are people wanting to take away your whole lifestyle in the name of this fraudulent climate emergency. Do not be swayed by people with self-serving agendas, people who will make lots of money at your expense if you buy into this climate emergency message. Do not listen to government or your politicians. I have lost entire faith in almost all politicians. The evidence that I have accumulated over my whole lifetime of business, but particularly over the last 3 years, shows how craven and corrupt politicians, bureaucrats, government have become. Do your own thinking. I assure you that I do my own. Now, I love the planet. What evidence is there for that? Well, my family has owned an organic farm for over 47 years. No chemicals. Why? Because my wise father encouraged us to buy that property so that we could produce our own healthy food. Without healthy food, you will not be healthy. I have invested time, energy, money into that farm, into many activities that I take that support the whole issue of organic, regenerative agriculture. I have proven my commitment. I've proven my love for this planet. I have invested time, energy, money in industrial hemp, and it can solve many of the emergencies to which I've referred. I say there's no climate emergency. There is a soil emergency. There is a landscape emergency. There is a waste emergency. I urge you to visit the website of Peter Andrews, OAM. His site is peterandrewsoam.com. He is an Australian landscape expert, 40 plus years of research. He is a water and hydrology expert. Mary Cole, Dr. Mary Cole, is a soil biologist. There is clearly a soil emergency. And there's a waste emergency. One tiny example, because I can't go too long, is the plastic waste that is in our environment. Now we have microplastics in fish, and you are eating fish products and animal products that have microplastic in them that then starts to accumulate in your body. These emergencies are created by the industrial, military, chemical, and pharmaceutical complex. There are powerful elites, wealthy elites, driving this whole agenda of causing the soil emergency, the landscape emergency, the waste emergency. Big corporations produce huge amounts of waste and then just dump it in landfill. They are not held to account. Fortunately, now there is conversation around what's called the circular economy. There is conversation around the environment, but it's in the name of climate emergency. No, there is no climate emergency. I love the planet. There is no climate emergency. I want you to drill that into your brain. When someone says to you there's a climate emergency, say, no, there's not. And people who will attack you because they think you don't love the planet because you don't acknowledge there's a climate emergency, that's the fraud. That's the fraud that leads you giving away your freedoms. Do not confuse the problems. The climate emergency is designed to encourage you to give away your freedoms, to give away your freedom to travel, to give away your freedom to drive a petrol-driven car, to give away your freedom to have affordable, available electricity. Do you know there's a direct correlation between electricity and GDP? These elitists will take away your electricity or make it unaffordable in the name of climate emergency. GDP drops, your health will drop, your health will suffer. They don't want you to eat meat, all in the name of cows farting. Eat insects and bugs and crickets, all bad for you. Your health will suffer, your family's health will suffer if you accept this fraud. And just look at who makes money. You've got to follow the money trail. When you don't understand why something is happening, look who's making money. Julie told me that in the transgender game, talking about the pharmaceutical complex, the transgender game, each person who transitions from one sex to another, there's only two of them, male and female, the lifetime value of pharmaceutical drugs for that transition person is between $7 to $8 million per person, all paid by the taxpayer, of course. Follow the money trail. There are rent seekers and carpetbaggers influencing politicians to convince them that there's a climate emergency and then give subsidies, taxpayer, your money, to get them to put in alternative energy systems, all in the name of reducing CO2. A gas essential for life that is now being demonized. Look who's getting money from these games. Not one of the elites will suffer from the increasing cost of electricity. They will have their private jets, as you've seen them, travel to Davos. This is designed to weed out the middle class and have a small number of elites and the bulk of us suffering poverty, all in the name of saving the planet. I say it's BS and it's fraudulent. There are many ways to solve our problems, our soil problems, our landscape problems, our waste problems. You see, the elites won't make as much money out of that as the climate emergency fraud. Follow the money. Do your own thinking. Study Bjorn Lomborg's work at the Copenhagen Institute if you want a good place to start. I've done my own research. I continue to do my own research. I love this planet. I want to deeply understand what's happening. And I'm firmly of the view over the past 50 years of my understanding and research that there is no climate emergency. Speak up. Don't let these politicians, these greens who say they're speaking in the name of love of planet, defraud you. So, let me give you some resources. The song this week by ABBA. I love ABBA. I grew up, you know, in 1974. I just finished university. And then the song is, of course, money, money, money. It must be funny. In a rich man's world. Just think of that song, money, money, money. These elitists are after your money, 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 and they're using climate emergency to get it. Don't give it to them. They sing that song and say, up you, elites, you're not having my money, you're not having my freedom, you're not having my health, and you're not going to block my freedom of speech. My book. Now, I'm going to show you some books. Look, I'll just give you some example of some books that I've got on my bookshelf. Climate Change, The Facts, 2020. Rex Ellis's wonderful story about his adventures in the Australian landscape. Green Fraud, Mark Morano. Green Murder, and this is my recommended book, but all these other books I read just to give you evidence that I'm researching this. Green Murder by Ian Plimer, excellent book. And then I've also invested in the Carbon Almanac that is trying to justify the climate emergency. It is full of misleading data. But my point of showing you these books is I'm not just speaking off the cuff. I invest my time and do my own thinking, which is what I'm urging you to do. So the book is Green Murder by Ian Plimer. I've recommended it before, but it's particularly relevant to this. And I'm also acutely conscious that you don't watch every episode, you don't listen to every episode, so I might have recommended something in the past, but you've got no idea that I recommended that in the past, so that's part of the challenge. My health tip arises from my interview yesterday of Dr. Luke Fuller on TNT Radio. My weekly show is on TNT Radio at 4 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time. Every week for 1 hour, Dr. Luke Fuller is a physiotherapist and osteopath. And we're having a conversation and we agreed that keeping a diary of what's happening with your body, with the aches and the pains and clues that you might have is a useful thing to do so that when you go to a professional who says, well, how long has this pain been happening? What sort of pain is it? How many times a day does it happen? What have you been eating? Keeping a diary to raise your awareness of what's happening to your body. This also applies to headaches is a useful thing to do. My spiritual tip this week is to think about and explore community groups to which you can make a contribution. Making a contribution to your community is a spiritual exercise. You give of yourself. Which community group can you give to or create your own? Because if the climate emergency fraud succeeds, we will need to create our own communities. You might think about starting a community, or if you don't know which community to join, come and ask me, and I'll happily share some connections with you. My quote this week is from Eleanor Roosevelt. She said this, "You gain strength, courage, and confidence by every experience in which you really stop to look fear in the face. You must do the thing which you think you cannot do." You gain strength, courage, and confidence by every experience in which you really stop to look fear in the face. I urge you to do that. And whilst before, I'm not talking about reviewing the week, but during the week I went to the funeral of Margaret Lum. 94 years old she was, and she looked fear in the face. It was wonderful to hear her life story. She's my brother-in-law's mother, or my sister's mother-in-law, and 94 years, an amazing life. And she became an orphan at the age of 17 in 1945 at the end of the war in the UK. Wonder how many times she looked fear in the face. And a spot of humour. An honest politician is one who, when you've given him money to buy him, he stays bought. An honest politician is one who is once bought and remains bought. I have very little faith in the vast majority of politicians. They are so self-serving. They are not interested in you. It's now one of the big lies. I'm from the government. I'm here to help you. That is no longer true. It might have been more true in the 60s and the 70s. Certainly not now. So take today's big idea. Think about the work that you're going to do to educate yourself properly on this issue of what emergencies there really are. Carbon dioxide is not a harmful gas. And this show is designed to help you raise your self-awareness and encourage you to live with passion, to pursue what is really important to you. And if you want to make good decisions in life, then I urge you to understand this question, because it's an existential threat to us. You can follow the rest of my work at coves.com, charlescoves.com. If you enjoy this program, please ask your family, friends, and work colleagues to subscribe to the podcast or to the channels. And if you want to know more about the various programs, look at my websites and my books, Passionate People Produce and Passionate Performance, are also available at those sites. Now, let's review some key happenings during the week. As I said, my TNT radio program is not now on every week. You can listen to the recordings of every show that I've done since the first episode on 15 January 2022. So it's now 15 months of that radio program. TNT Radio is a wonderful show. During the week, I also moderated the FOAM meetings, Fighters Opposing Autocratic Maniacs. That's our politicians, generally speaking, and the bureaucrats. During the week, I moderated the twice weekly meetings of the Medical Doctors for COVID Ethics, and JJ Cooey did a masterful presentation on the science. And then Amanda Dawn Vollmer did a wonderful analysis of holistic living, of holistic health. During the week, President Donald Trump was indicted. I say that the legal profession, the courts in America are being deeply, deeply politicized. This attempt on indicting Trump will backfire on the Democrats. It is absurd. As a matter of law, it's absurd. It is entirely politicization of the legal system, contrary to the whole Westminster system on how the Australian, Canadian, UK, and American systems are built. The whole idea of separation of powers. The Premier of Victoria, the worst in its entire history, returned from China. I say he went to China to get his instructions to arrange more money for the profligate spending that's going on. And the big build is resulting, the big build of all sorts of infrastructure in this city is causing massive, massive impacts on availability of workers, leading to all sorts of ripple effects in other industries, including housing, including collapse of major housing construction companies. And again, the fat cats are benefiting, getting huge salaries for running this big build, and huge indebtedness being incurred by this government. It is madness. I bring to your attention that only 36% of Victorians gave Daniel Andrews and the Labor Party their first preference. However, because people are sucked in by the climate emergency fraud, they gave 12% to the Greens Party, and its second preference is almost entirely Labor. And that's how Daniel Andrews got elected. Everybody, we need to understand the fraud of preferential system voting and how it can be manipulated for a premier to be re-elected with 36% for a vote for his party. Federally, the Federal Labor Party got less than 36%, again, on the preferential system. And I note during the week that the Prime Minister, Albo, is coming out with his fraudulent messages around the voice, to give voice to Australian Aborigines to change the Constitution. I say that's a fraud on the people, because when you look into it, as a lawyer, I've looked into this, it is a bad, bad strategy. And there is a hidden agenda behind it. I've had some views about what that hidden agenda is. Do not support this change to the Constitution. And tell your friends not to support it. And anybody who says you're racist because you don't support it is just literally an idiot. And they have a hidden agenda because they're rent seekers and carpetbaggers who want to get money from administering the Aboriginal game of getting more and more money, all in the name of reparation. During the work, I also saw a very disturbing video from Alice Springs, raised by Ben Fordham on 2GB radio in New South Wales, about the violence and the out of control Aboriginal community in Alice Springs, the fear that normal Aussies have of leaving their homes at night. It's a disaster that is not portrayed in the mainstream media. There's a fraud being perpetrated on the Australian people in many ways, and this is another one of the ways. And then lastly, let me assure you that Julie and I are happy. I'm happy. This is for the Catholics amongst you, or the Christians, this is Palm Sunday, where I'm recording this. And next week is Easter. So we're not going to have a program. So that's over the 3 years, the 10 episodes that we've missed essentially are to do with Easter and Christmas. So I think we've done pretty well to only miss 10 episodes, but we will certainly not be doing a show on Easter Sunday. And I hope that you have a wonderful Easter break if you organize it, if you go away. We certainly will be. We will make sure that we don't have too many chocolates, and I'll keep making sure that Julie keeps doing her exercise while I'm doing mine. So, if you're new to the show, stick around for the foundational principles of the show that will give you deeper understanding and further background about me. Again, thanks for watching or listening. And until our next show in 2 weeks' time, may your life be full of passion, full of challenge, and ever-increasing self-awareness so you live life on your terms. Thanks again. Bye. Now, for listeners and viewers who want to know more about my background and what else I do with my life, as well as the foundational principles for this show that's now over 140 episodes, here it is. Since 1993, when I left my legal career, a career that I loved, so this is now 30 years, I have inspired, motivated, and provoked people to discover and pursue their passion. I have helped people with the books that I've written, with speeches at conferences, with seminars, with work with companies, team building programs, and one-on-one executive coaching. I've done this work in big companies, small companies, in government entities. One of my core principles is that freedom is what makes us truly human. That's why one of the greatest threats of government that leads you to observe the law is the loss of your freedom via being jailed, incarceration. Without freedom, you and I are not much different to animals. This commitment I have for freedom is carried out by me primarily through 5 channels of activity. Number 1, I fight to preserve your freedom and everyone's freedom to pursue their passion. Number 2, inspiring you to be free through excellent health. Number three, helping preserve freedom globally through the expansion of industrial hemp. I'm CEO of a hemp company that manufactures the world's best machinery. Hemp is a miraculous crop that enables every community to thrive independently of government. And in this way, the power of government to take away your freedom is minimized. Of course, as a subset of that, I fight for freedom to drink coffee. Number four, I fight for freedom through legal strategies, through being the interface between lawyers and their clients, because clients don't understand lawyers and lawyers don't understand clients. And finally, as chairman of the Australian Institute of Comedy, I fight for freedom of thought and speech by comedians through humour, comedy and laughter, because suppressing the freedom of speech of comedians is the beginning of the end of freedom. The foundational principles for this weekly show are founded on the formula SA plus P equals S. Your self-awareness, SA plus P, your passion, equals S, your success. You will be successful when you have high self-awareness and you're pursuing your passion. The best definition of success that I have found over the years is this: success is the progressive realization of your worthy ideal. This show is also guided by Socrates' famous principle, the unexamined life is not worth living. You can see I'm wearing my red jacket. I always wear my red jacket in public presentations. Red is the color of passion. Each week I explore one big idea that can change your life. And it's just one big idea, because then there's a chance that you will remember it. If I share too many ideas, it all goes into fluff and you can't remember it and you keep doing what you've always done. I hope to inspire you to make one small change, just one thing. When I share that big idea, I then share some practical resources. You've heard what those six resources are: a song, the lyrics of a song, a book, a spiritual tip, a health tip, a quote, and of course, some humor. This show is not politically correct. And I love certain addictions, including coffee and exercise. And reading, and some unmentionable in polite company addictions. You can turn your mind to what you might think that might be. This show definitely subscribes to the view that we have a spiritual life. So if that offends you, don't watch, don't listen. I promise you I don't include anything in this show that I don't believe to be of value, that I don't believe to be useful. I would never accept sponsorship for a product that I didn't believe was of value. If you have any questions or suggestions, please email me at charles@coves.com. Again, thanks for listening to this last piece as well. I look forward to having you with me for future shows in the weeks and months to come. Bye.